Hot Rims. If somebody fancies getting an update from Hot Rims and also from Deftin as well about how Deftin's doing, we'll see where they are.
I'll just pop down to Hot Rims, see how they're getting on.
User left your channel.
I have to say, these buckyballers, I don't know what they've got in that. It's airborne. It's flying at one heck of a rate. I'm trying to match speed with them at the moment, but I reckon they must be going along at the top end of the 30s in this speed.
You can have Gooch's progress as your destination and me as your target.
No.
Well, I can confirm because I'm keeping pace with him. Buckyball Racer is running at 45. He's pulling away from me. He's on the surface. He's pulling 45 across the surface here. This is incredible to watch.
He is screaming along.
Actually, he's pulling away. He's just jumped a whole crater at 45. He hasn't even slowed down for the crater. He's just taken the whole crater.
Downhill?
In fact, I think he must be pulling as...
Oh, yeah.
46. He's pulling away from me. I'm pulling up 20 degrees to your left. Yeah, he's pulling high 40s, low 50s. This is absolutely incredible to watch.
So
he's approaching the first set of rolling hills now. He's that far ahead.
I am now the marker.
He has taken the most almighty jumps, and he's not using his thrusters for landing until right at the last second. Some amazing viewing watching this guy drive. His spotter is Commander Alec Turner. I've got no idea who the racer is who's doing this, but his spotter is Alec Turner.
To go that fast. Good question. I do not know. I didn't think mine went
user
above 32.
Your channel.
Okay, Hot Rims are at 431. Overt Pretension are at 445. Biosh Goodmain is at 433.
Well, this guy racing here I'm watching
You're
is at 384.
He is pulling the best part of
50Ks along the ground. He is jumping and boosting for huge sections of it to avoid his wheels causing any friction in the ground. This guy really knows his stuff.
Rykdar, I'm having trouble finding you.
Nah, well, never mind. The beacon is a long way behind me now.
Hey guys, this is Arson Cross. I'm just chiming in at 429 kilometers.
Fantastic, thank you. Well, our leaders are currently at 383.
Fucking hell. What are we, 47?
475. It looks like our lead solo driver is just behind them as well.
Wow.
So Team Mummy, let's have a look how far behind me is Team...
Team Mummy
is 5Ks Brampton. Behind the leader. So our lead solo racer is 5Ks behind the lead team.
Team Mummy is Brampton Timmy, if that's the person you're watching.
That's the one, yep. So he's 5Ks behind the leaders.
Yeah, a bit more to your left there, mate.
Is he a solo?
Watch out for that massive
one. And he's in solo.
Yeah, that one.
Down to 65% hole, though.
Maybe I shouldn't have said anything. Okay. It looks flat-ish, apart from some rocks where I am.
Commander Furry Cat, who's acting as spotter, has just clipped the rim of a crater in her Diamondback Scout. Furry Cat could be a guy, actually. I'm mistaking some of our cats with our other kittens. So Furry Cat could be a guy, and Furry Cat, now he's skirting the rim of this crater. I'm just going to do a flyby on his Diamondback. Here we go.
Gone quiet. What's our distance? 473. Okay. Sneevis here, reporting for the gene pool. Our Odometer reads 473 left.
Pardon? 473? Okay. Got that. All logged.
Anything you read out, I'll pop into the Twitch channel.
I'm at 470 now.
Hober or Splendor, could you just do a bit of a snapshot for people on the Facebook page as to where the lead are and where the tail end are? Doesn't matter if it's a couple of minutes out, but do you mind?
Ahead. Yep, not a problem.
I'll try and get some altitude so I can see where the flask
goes. Okay, so here at the front of the race, we have Commander Furry Cat, who is parked in a diamond back. We have the rest of the Buckaball racers coming. What's that coming over the hill? It's a Buckaball. Up behind Commander Furry Cat. So they're running two spotters, one advanced spotter for long range and one local spotter for terrain.
You know what I just said about them running two spotters? They're running two spotters.
I can see the headlights of the lead racer from their team. They're in a wing of four here.
Yeah, I think just go for the point
now. Still pulling over 40 k's, nearer 50, over the surface at most times. So running a good 30% faster than the rest of the teams out there, I can see.
I must be using that.
Okay.
Fuel
upgrade. I can just fly lower, which is what I've been doing.
There's no such thing in the SRVs, is it?
Yeah. Well, you've got three sorts of three levels.
Cool. I won't read out each
one.
Yeah,
there must be.
Yeah, but that only improves your efficiency. That doesn't.
Yeah, well, I can't get above 37. So I don't know how they're getting 50.
Yeah, you need to come straight to me.
Unless they've got better fuel.
A lot of airtime, an awful lot of airtime.
There you go. I was going to say
less friction.
So they're using the ground to build up speed, but as soon as they've got a boost, they're just taking straight back up again and jumping every obstacle they're jumping.
Which team are in the lead, Dave?
What's that?
Which team are in the lead? Is it the Buckyballs?
This is Buckyball Racers in the lead. We've got Mummy, Timmy, Bradston in second. The Elite Racers are 404 Ks out, so they are about 20 Ks behind.
Yeah.
But I'm on the lead racer at the moment.
Oh,
he stopped. The lead racer has stopped. Hang on a second.
Selecting my next.
Is he going for repairs? Is he having a pee? No, and he's off again. I think he stopped for repairs. It looks like he's probably stopped for repairs.
Are they about 373?
Yeah, 372.
They're 100 kilometres ahead of me.
Yeah, they're running about 30% faster than everybody else. And, I mean, no word of fibs or underhand behaviour. These guys are really going for it.
Right, head straight, but watch out for a crater to your left. Oh shit, if I can avoid crashing, that would be good. Yeah. Okay, yeah, good. Now, bear back onto Gooch's progress.
Right, somebody want to take over a little bit of commentary duties for a bit? I'm putting it on external camera and parking for a sec. Anybody got any Galnet articles to read out? Feel free.
Some
I can read the latest episode. Oh no, I can't read the latest episode. The Dockers.
If you're sat in your SRVs wondering how the mineral collection is doing it for the CG, currently stands at 1.66 million tons collected, 1,135 contributors with 5 days left, about 75% of the way into tier 3.
Back too soon. Oops.
Okay, Galnet News Weekly Expansion Report. This report represents the latest data on expansion among the galaxy's minor factions. Here are the latest factions that have expanded into new systems. Malibata Purple Bridge Comms, Confederacy of Mandubi, Nagaran's League, the Guardians of Harmony, LHS 304, Crimson Dynamic Co., HIP 58213 Cooperative,
wow.
Keluin Patrons Principles.
Oh, because this is
Bodhinga Empire Assembly, the Silver Life Co.
Oh, so you just
Uniting Quamadi.
Fair enough.
Oh, I've not heard of any of those.
Your light is spinning all the way around.
I was going to say they're not big players in the galaxy, but I've never heard of them. Does anybody actually care about the power play report? No.
No,
we'll skip that one. Right. Power play, it's still as tedious as ever. Things happened. It doesn't really affect you. Yes. Quick congratulations to the Distance World Explorers. They've travelled over 65,000 light years. I don't think it's as hardcore as the Hogan's Run that we're doing today. And they've made it all the way to, was it Beagle's Point? I don't know, I don't really get that exploring stuff. Anybody else got any comments on exploring?
They're renaming the system after them, aren't they, as well? In the next patch. That Beagle's Point is actually going to be called Beagle's Point henceforth.
Well, that's cool.
One of the blokes who runs it just obligatorily killed it, that I believe.
Yeah, Aramis, the first person to make it out that far, called it Beagle's Point himself, but it's still just got an automatically generated system name at the moment.
Ooh, I've got two pythons inbound.
A nearby system to theirs getting named after his ship as well, isn't it, I think?
No, we've got Commander JC. Right of me. Let me just have a chat with him.
There's other rocks in front of you. You can go between them. Yeah, you're right. But there's a drop coming up now.
Some more important news. July, I believe it's the 11th or the 13th, is LaveCon 2006 in Northampton. Is anybody here going to LaveCon?
Yes.
Oh, yes. No, fair enough.
All right, that's three of us. Great.
10 degrees to your right.
I might be taking a dartboard along.
Dartboard or two. You might need to, looking at the amount of people you've got to leap me.
Yeah, I'll be there.
And now... Which points of LaveCon are you most looking forward to?
The bar.
Say the darts. Yep. Say the darts.
The darts!
Never been to LaveCon before, so anything will be cool.
What the fuck did you do?
No, it's good. It was my first time last year, and it was great meeting a lot of people that I had played the game with, meeting a lot of people that I now play the game with and didn't realise I'd met, but everybody remembered me. Which is, I don't know whether I'm famous or infamous.
Try to get back on.
Know the feeling.
You're infamous.
Yeah, I probably am. Infamous.
They've all got it in for us.
Safe to say, I won't be wearing a monk's outfit this year.
Do not go straight for it. You want to probably carry on going the direction you're facing.
I've got something a lot better.
No, we're not doing a for the monk.
I reckon this is probably your best bet.
Yeah, hashtag for the monk. Doesn't really cut it.
Are we starting a Truclarian jihad, are we?
I don't think we're allowed to start any jihad at LaveCon.
Not even the Truclarian one.
We worship the mug.
No, it would be a Truclarian convoy.
Oh, you're close than I thought.
I've got some seriously bumpy ground now.
Would that mean that we worship Mug Halud?
I think...
and the little truckers.
I think straight is probably your best bet. I'm marking a hazard.
You need to spice that story up a bit.
Oh come on. Get some water of the maker and wash it up a little bit.
I am a hazard.
That was a bit of a Harkonnen pun, I think.
How about I trade you some of me mugs?
Right, it's safer to go to your left, or my left, your left.
Has everybody run out of June puns?
Yes, I don't know, please. I'll Bene Gesserit some more out the back of the truck.
I will kill him!
Yeah, that massive rock was what I was...
Oh, Jesus. I've seen he's got a bit mad.
You didn't hit it, so...
A bit mad.
Crashed again.
If you can head to a little bit of good news I heard this week. Elite Encounters pen and paper role playing game will be released in July, which happens to be about the same time that Elite LaveCon's on, so I'm assuming that may be the official launch party for it. So those of you who've purchased the book from Dave Hughes and his Kickstarter, expect to hear some really good news about what's coming out quite soon. I also know that he's incorporated Lave Radio's Phoenix Defier, aka Colin. He's introduced his tabletop like space flag? Fighting game. Oh, got a flat so bottom. You can also play that. Drew Wagar recently announced that he will be releasing the last and final bits of all the lore to do with the leech you're ever going to get for him, because Frontier don't want to give him any money, and he does it for free.
I should probably just stop watching you, and yeah, a bit to the right over this way, probably better for you.
Anybody else got any elite-related news they want to talk about? 2.1 speculation?
No, apparently there's a group of nutters racing over a planet today.
Oh, he gives a toss about them. User joined your channel. I'm a little bit confused, because the winner of this gets a cup, but doesn't that kind of defeat the objective for the mug? Because you're technically doing this for the cup, but for the mug at the same time.
Trophy.
Progress appears to be in a circle at the moment.
Jesus, you lot are a tough crowd to work.
Oh, come on, I'm concentrating.
They got concentration tongue out at the moment.
God, what I just left in cubicle 3, it filled more than a cup.
Yeah, just reset it.
Oh, no. I spent so long while everyone was at Leap Meat cleaning that stuff up. And
there are some massive rocks.
Everybody came back with lawn sausage and haggis and black pudding. And yeah, it's back in
what
the same
hell
situation.
Is a lawn sausage?
It's a square sausage.
That rock there, for example.
Almost big enough to fit. It's a thin slice of bread. It is the perfect sausage. But it's made out of the cheapest sausage meat.
Hmm. There's another massive rock to it.
Mostly sawdust down.
Ah, your mom.
That sounds
no. To be fair, the more sawdust you put in, it probably tastes better.
Good square sausage is actually good. Cheap square sausage generally isn't.
Probably a good route, this, actually. Probably on a good bearing. Yeah, yeah.
If anybody's watching the Twitch stream right now, it seems Brabston Timmy is just spinning in midair on Dave's stream. I'm not quite sure what's going on there.
Actually, I'm wondering how many times Dave's going to hit the ground tonight.
Well, he's already down to 38% hole. Is that the Hot Riddens team that have jumped in? No, we've got Iceni. I don't know what happened there.
Oh, your ass just skimmed it.
Timmy's gone into orbit, almost.
Well, this is what... He is actually 14 kilometres away from Dave, who's pointing at the sky, or unless he's fallen through the map.
Yeah,
which would make sense. That makes sense with the position of the SRV on his scanner.
He's ascending.
Not allowed to tunnel under. Make it easier, are you?
Slightly to your right. Yeah.
No, you're definitely not allowed Thunderbird 5.
Oh, watch that rock.
Right, yeah. Commentators, how's it going? I'm not quite back yet.
Oh,
it seems
wrong
you've
way
fallen
up,
through
dude.
The floor.
Yeah, no, everybody else is falling through the ceiling, but I've just, yes, somebody else has started up a live TV download as I was doing this.
72%? Yeah,
Commander Fletcher, right. You're a bad man.
Okay.
So far, we're just having general chit-chat. Nobody wanted to hear about power play.
Like a cunt.
Just been chatting.
Big rock
if
right.
Anybody hasn't listened to or wants to listen to Lave Radio, then I'd recommend it. I'd highly recommend it. It's the weekly podcast about the news of Elite and the happenings going on. Kind of an objective view outside of the actual game, so it's quite interesting. There's also Dockers, which is the spoof comedy series set on a star, set on a station. It's a little bit like The Office or The Airport, if you've watched any of those British comedy shows. Hilariously funny. They've got some people with some amazing voice acting, myself included. Comes out periodically.
Sporadically it comes out.
Well, it's not sporadically, it's periodically at the moment. I think we've got the second part of the Christmas special at Easter.
And where does one pick up such listening gems?
So, for Lave Radio, you want to go to laveradio.com. That comes out every Tuesday night at 8:30 GMT.
You're also found on that site Escape Velocity.
Yes, yes. Escape well Velocity, the audio drama written by Christopher Jarvis.
One and two. Production standards and everything.
He's also just put on Patreon Series 3 of Escape Velocity, so if you enjoy listening to Series 1 and 2, then you can sign up and pay, I think the minimum is something like $4 or $8 per episode. Very small change.
I'm facing the same way you are.
Yeah. Chris said that he basically wanted everybody just to give £1, you know, and that would make him feel happy, which is why I'm giving him £1.
So, I was listening to before the game actually was released. So, and we got, I don't know whether anybody listens to any of the stuff.
You can also find Dockers on bs-dockers.co.uk. I think there's about 12 episodes recorded and 2 live from LaveCon 2015 and 2014. Highly recommend 2015 with the Lisping Monk.
The live's happening this
year. Detect a bit of bias there, Homer.
I don't know what you mean.
User in your channel timed out.
There will also be a live recording at this year's LaveCon, so nice. Expect midnight on a Saturday to watch very drunk people line up on a stage with more people on the stage than their audience watching them.
What's that URL again for the Dockers?
bs-dockers.co.uk.
If you can. And I can vouch for it being very funny.
Although it's not that long.
If you're going to watch the live LaveCon stuff, I'd recommend watching the video rather than listening to the sound, because it's much funnier, and you'll also get to see the Crash bobblehead bouncing in the background.
Big rock in front of you.
I wouldn't recommend listening to Dockers on a bus or any form of public transport, because you will quickly be described as a weirdo laughing to himself on the bus.
Big rock.
But it is acceptable to listen to at work as long as you play it as loud as you can to everybody else.
Yep.
It's definitely work suitable.
That would be a good way of sliding into it, yep.
Oh, we're getting...
I had an old woman moving away from me.
I'm afraid we've lost Vin. He's had a serious crash, which means the Twitch is down.
Medic!
Somebody take his computer to PC World.
Until we can resurrect
him. No, we wanted to fix it.
Yeah, he was doing a stream though.
Well,
big rocks to your
until we can resurrect him, front, any to problems, go a bit... questions, queries about the race, with me, I will attempt to sort people out.
While Spender does that, I'll just carry on chatting crap at you lot.
Alright, that works. Okay, there's another one just
so
the
if you
other
wanted to look at the Elite Encounters
rulebook,
or the Elite Encounters role-playing game, I believe it's daftworks.co.uk. Let me just double-check that URL. It is Daftworks, that is the home of the Elite RPG, created by our lovely Dave Hughes, who is probably one of the nicest people I've ever met. I played the role-playing game myself down at Elite Meet 2014 down in Birmingham, and it was a hell of a laugh. I also played it with Commander Splendor at LaveCon 2015, whilst I was very hungover myself. Commander Remklep Penfold decided that they'd have a fight in about the first 3 minutes of the game, and it ended up with me walking out with 2 corpses.
Yep.
To be fair, they weren't technically corpses. They were
there's a big hole
people
coming up.
Who would be corpses fairly shortly without medical attention.
Well, yes, but, you know, that's what happens when you mess
and
with
then
the secret
once
police.
Pass me,
what was that about Penfold and Remklep?
LaveCon 2015 on the Sunday, whilst I think everybody was incredibly hungover, myself more so than most, we had a game of the Elite role-playing game with Splendor as our GM, and it was it probably lasted about 15-20 minutes, but within about 3 minutes it started off with... Penfold and Remklep deciding to shoot each other, and then I stepped in and thought, well, I might as well just kill the both of them.
Big rocks, by the way.
Excellent. So, for those in Twitch, I don't know if you've got all the links I've read out, so in a minute, once Vin's back on, I will post all the gubbins I've just been chatting about that is Elite-related and you may or may not know about. And it's definitely a lot of things that are quite enjoyable.
There's a massive rock.
I mean, hands up, who's listened to Late Radio?
Put my hand up, but you can't see me.
I've got something else up, if that counts.
Thank you for that, Skip Rap.
I don't want to crash.
start seeing.
Just flash your lights then.
I'm also listening and live streaming too.
The elite books, I got a question about those. Are they available from the Frontier store, or do you buy them directly from the author's pages?
You can get most of them from the Frontier store, but you can most of them are available in electronic form from Amazon. Also, half of them were published by Fantastic Books, and you can get them directly from their website, along with the audio book versions thereof.
Which you can also get from Audible.
Yep. Yes, and pretty much all the ones that have been recorded in audio form are available at Audible.
You're right.
Which were recorded by Chris Jarvis, who is doing the Elite Escape Velocity series. So, very good practice for him, because he basically started Escape Velocity thinking, I want to do a job where I make audio dramas, and he did two series worth of his own money's worth of series, and then got commissioned to do, what is it, four books?
Four of them recorded now, yep.
I believe it's five, if you count Lave Revolution, if it ever gets released.
The lawyers have asked us not to speak about this.
Yes.
Why?
It's currently going through the courts. Out between the author and the publisher, so yes. the audio version of that may not be arriving anytime soon.
For the moment?
Well, I've just got a quick Facebook message from Jimmy Dunn, who I assume is listening in. he says, still waiting on the Thargoids or some pirates to show up and mess up the fun, lol.
You're just passing a smallish crate on your left. Yeah, well, this is a good bearing, this is.
Looks like Dave is back in his ship. And he's joined the room. Vin, are you back on air? Yeah.
I am, but it doesn't look my voice is going out at all to the Twitch stream. So anybody got ears on the Twitch stream, can you hear my voice?
It hasn't been since you started this morning.
I wish somebody could have told me.
Sorry, my Twitch stream.
Are you serious?
Serious. It hasn't been going all day.
So all the commentary, nobody actually messaged me to say there was no sound coming out.
I heard it.
You could hear the TeamSpeak side of it, but not your voice side of it.
I heard most of it. I unmuted the Twitch sound because it was just doubling up.
Yeah, to be honest with you, Dave, when I had Twitch on, it was when we were still setting up before you had your disconnect issue. So I might have fucked up then.
No, I hadn't pushed a button, so we've had none of my commentary for the entire thing.
No, when I had the Twitch stream going through the mobile earlier, your commentary was coming through every now and then.
You're on now, mate, you're on.
Oh well, no worries. Can you hear me? I've got open mic now.
Yeah, I can hear
you. I'm trying to catch up with everybody else. So, I've got me track IR on, so if everybody on the TeamSpeak, it's all gone a bit crazy now. On the Twitch TV. We're trying to find out where the leaders are, so I'm just going to message down to... Where are they? Osric. And where are you now?
Well... I'm 445 kilometers away, and I seem to be on a ridge between two big craters.
Okay. I'm going to turn my ship sounds back down again because it's getting a little bit noisy. If I can do that before I crash and burn, that would be even better. Back to game menu and resume. Well, I'm really sorry for everybody who's been watching on the Twitch stream about that. I wish somebody had shouted out that they can't hear what's going on. Anyway, I'm now catching back up with the leaders again. Commander Brabston, Timmy, is down to 81% hull. I can now see, coming over the horizon on my ship, there is a large mountain. Ah, well, Watcher says, can we have an update? Yeah, I'm just catching up with the leaders. I had a complete system crash a minute ago. So, at the front, we did have the Buckyball Racers. Now, they are negotiating some pretty evil terrain here, so there's a route planning going on. They were in the lead. We are currently, let's have a look at our distances, 338. Yep, 338, so 330 by the time I caught him up from the finish line. We still have our lead two teams, which are the Buckyball Racers, spotted by Alec Turner and the Furry Cat in the lead, and then Timmy Brabston, who is Team Mummy, who's our lead solo racer, is just behind them, and they are driving like you have never seen it before, but they're coming up on some dangerous terrain. Osric is having some instancing nightmares, so they're having difficulties. So they're coming up on a large set of crevasses. They are 322 kilometers from Gooch at the moment, and they seem to be in the lead.
Yep, the second race that they're just coming up to is the first real obstacle. Unless you pick a very good course through it,
Okay, we then have Overt Pretension running at 420 kilometers, so they are all of 100 kilometers behind the lead at the moment. Do we have any updates from any other teams? Or does anybody fancy dropping down to another channel to check?
Solo?
444. 444, so you're running 120 behind the leaders. These guys are really going for it. If anybody can drop a message through to Commander Deftin, D-E-F-T-I-N, I think he was with the Elite Racers, and we want to see where Deftin is. So if anybody can get an update from Deftin for us, that'd be fantastic. Okay.
Commander Jintosh is at 441.
441, so Jintosh is actually not doing too bad there in solo. Okay, we have the leaders of the race have just dropped into the first set of the gullies and canyons. We have Commander Brabston just leaping off a cliff down into this gully. Moment, here we go. He has gone straight off the edge of a cliff and he's using his thrusters. He is doing a proper base jump here. So we have video on the base jump. Taking a lateral path down there, probably sensible. Any consolation? My hull on the spotter ship is down to 39%, so I might be dying on the spotter ship. Commander Brabston has taken a wrong turn. He's heading straight towards some seriously bad... Oh, where's he going? He's going away from the destination now. He's lost. Right, back to the leaders. We have the Buckyball Racers. I'm flying over to them at the moment. We have Commander Osric. We have Alec Turner. We have Diamondback Scout of the Furry Cat. And whoever is still got the wheels on the ground has now entered the deepest of the canyons from this section of the race. It is looking pretty leery out there. He is just taken another base jump. These guys are base jumping as well, down a cliffside into a gully. So here we go. I have no idea. Oh god, he's crashed! 69% on his hull. But he's back up on his wheels. He's lost his momentum. And the thing about this section of the race is there is nowhere to land ships nearby. So if you get into trouble at around, where are we here, 322 kilometers away, there are very few places in this section where you can put a rescue ship down. Okay, we've got the Cross Corporation at 382. We have Goodmain at 378. and somebody's talking about Elite Encounters role-playing games. Well, you don't want any role-playing, you want real flying. Okay, they're now doing some gully racing. So we've got the buckyball racers down with the gully racing. Is anybody flying over? Hoba, how's your team? Are you flying over a team at the moment?
I'm not. I've currently just been chatting with everyone, updating the links on Twitch, so everybody can understand what I'm on about.
Fantastic. The speeds these guys are doing, I mean, I'm watching it again. I know I was talking about this earlier, and for the benefit of those on the Twitch stream, I'm trying to keep pace with this lead racer channel. Using my ship, and he must be pulling, let's have a look, 40... Yeah, he's pulling currently, even in the gullies, 38, a speed of 39 here in the gullies. Right, now he's going for a hill climb, so at the lead of the race, we have the Buckyball Racers
User disconnected from the chat.
For a hill climb out of this gully. He's picked the steepest route. He's gone straight up on thrusters, over the top. He's pulled a barrel roll, currently upside down. He's got enough thrusters to get down safely, or are we going to see a detonation here? Though he has put it down as feather light as it comes on the top of the mountain, he's out of the gully having jumped straight out from the ground.
Looks like my own highest of the race duration.
I think, pending problems. I mean, these guys have actually got to make it alive down to the end. They've got their spotters.
User joined your channel.
I suspect this guy is running with many repairs and refuels on board as well. His escort Diamondback Scout, piloted by Commander at the moment, Alec Turner, is doing a cracking job on close spotting. And then we have Commander Osric, who's running about, I can see over my right-hand side here, he's running a couple of kilometers ahead, looking for a safe route right through the next section. I'm going to pull some altitude here to see whether I can get eyes on the rest of the terrain here. So we're pulling up to an altitude now of a couple of kilometers. And you can see from the live feed here over to my port side here. See the headlights in the distance there of our second runner, who's trying to catch up out of that gully. Then over to the starboard side, you can see Commander Osric over there in the distance, plotting a course round that gully. And over here, as you can see, the mountain range that you've got across right in the distance, complete with that scary looking peak. Okay, Team Hot Rims are running at 376 kilometers, so that at least they're in the same 100 as the leaders. Does anybody have any shout outs or requests for the rest? No, or am I just going to keep wittering on for the whole flaming thing? I wonder whether this team indulge in the Breakfast of Champions.
User joined your channel.
Judging by their racing, they must have done. Right. I'm giving the viewers on the Twitch channel a long view. Elite Racers are 338 kilometers out, so they are within spitting distance of this lead team. One disaster by the lead team, and the Elite Racers could be on them. Team Yellow Insanity, that's Fazerina Van Castar, is still 500 kilometers. I don't know what he's been doing. He probably went the wrong way. Right, we have Commander Osric. He's heading for space. He has left in his white asp. So Commander Osric has left, maybe to refuel, maybe to buy some more stuff. Let's head down to the races and have a look what we have on the planet's surface. Oh, no, he hasn't. He's got wheels on the ground. He's dismissed his ship. So we have a second SRV from the Elite Racers. Right on the ground at the moment. They have tagged another team member, and I would imagine that's why his ship's been dismissed. I can't see his racer here at the moment. So if anybody can message Commander Osric or Ferrycat in-game to get an update on where they are, that would be fantastic for us. Do we have any other updates? Right, where is Psycho? Psycho Cow's disappeared. What other teams do we have? We have Hot Rims 1 and 2, they merged. We've got the Ribbit team, so we've got
Ben Moss Woodward and the Scooby Loo Kosh and the Angry Vegan. We need to find out where they are as well.
410. Hot Rims at 376. Van Caster's Yellow and Sam. Fancy at 500.
I was with the team about half an hour ago, and they were about 30 kilometres behind.
Excuse the coughing. These guys have now hit a flat section, so they've come out of those gullies. Let's swing back and see whether we can get the camera onto... see him. We've lost him at the moment. Solo racer who's following them. He's not dropping behind, but I can't... hoping we haven't lost him completely.
Gone over a
cliff?
Yeah. No, just landed. Through the air.
Flight assist on.
Oh! There's some kind of face on the other side of this.
Okay, it looks like our lead solo racer may be out now.
I'm just messaging him.
Tim Brabston, I've lost him. He was just behind the lead group here. I'm hunting for his wreckage at the moment. Doing a flyby of the land here, looking for his wreckage. Of course, if he's streaming, he may well have a face marker that he can look up for himself. Oh, it looks like we have lost.
Yeah, I'm getting no response from Brabston. It's not to say he's not driving though.
Being across the surface at the moment. Okay, message from Timmy Brabston. Doing all right, screwed up somewhere and ended up in some bad terrain, but I'm still okay.
I'm just going to say 311 kilometers. That's from Brabston.
Excellent. Well, I've now lost leaders. I'm just going to go hunting, see if we can find the leaders again. Here we go. We've got Commander Alec Turner in the lead here. So the lead group look like they are... and they've taken quite an oblique route around this one. So they are 308... give or take a bit, 308 kilometres out now, so the second group are only 30k's behind them. They seem to have slowed down quite considerably, these guys. I don't know if they've changed drivers, possibly a driver changeover.
Plus the terrain isn't helping.
Oh no, they're on the flat now, they're back out of the nasty terrain, they're back on the flat.
I'm currently trying to fly over where Brabston is. See if I can see him.
Yeah, I've got him now. I'll drag you in. Are you in a wing already, Hober?
Nope.
Well, you are now.
The constancing has not been kind to me so far. I've spent at least half my time in this race just trying to get into the right into the right license.
Right, these guys are barreling along again. Okay, so we are out approximately 3/5 of the race left to go. So 2/5 done. And we're back on the flat terrain. I can see the spotters way ahead. This is some incredible driving. They're back on the flat now.
Just going to refresh my instance.
Yeah, so the tactics these guys are using is that they've got their leader Osric, who's actually doing long range targeting, it looks like, for paths, so that the others can target him at a distance. They've got two local spotters looking out for terrain for him as well. Go. Right, the Diamondback Explorer has shot off into the distance of this team. I'm going to park this camera and we're going to watch what's going on with this team, because this is appears to be a lesson in how to do it properly. As far as I can tell, the driver at the rear doesn't currently have a spotter. Oh no, the furry cat is there. The most impressive thing is these guys are still doing it in open. They've not jumped down to a private group for improved frame rates or anything. They don't mind me flying over them and slowing things down. They're doing it in open. Which rocks. Right. Well, the terrain up ahead of the lead group now. We have a ridge. If they get this right, they're going to be driving right along the top of this ridge here ahead of me. So if you can see ahead of my ship. Yep, they've confirmed. 290 km out. Now, they're either going to go down the ridge, barreling through the middle, but we're going to watch in a minute as they approach this dangerous looking bridge. Might get round these couple. And you can see over in the distance these looming mountains, this shield wall of mountains is getting larger and larger. Okay, so the Redliners are now at 325 kilometers, so they are not far behind this lead group. They're actually catching up slightly, so well done, the Redliners. Somebody wants to message them to tell them to get the pedal down, they might be able to overtake at the end here. Not that we're at the end. By message from Commander Osric, he can see Furry Cat, but Kligish driving the SRV can't see him. So, Osric is spotter for Furry Cat is spotter for Kligish.
Hi guys, Just say that Frog's solo at the moment. In private. We just want to know what general standings are, how we're doing.
Okay, well, the general standings are, I didn't realise that my voice wasn't coming over the Twitch stream, but it is now. No, we have in the lead, it appears to be the Buckyball Racers, who are skitting at around the 290 mark. We then have a solo racer who's following them up about 5 or 6 kilometres behind, which is Tim Brabston from Team Mummy. He's doing it solo.
User left your channel.
We then have behind there, who have we got? We've got
the Redliners.
The Redliners are running at around 325 kilometres. We've got the Yellow Insanity Hutton team at 500 kilometres. We have the Hot Rims team. They're about 100 k's behind the leaders. And they've merged the two teams after some disasters. We have the SDC, who were doing all right, but they left without mugs, so they had to go and get some mugs. So, yeah, the lead is at 290 at the moment. How about you guys? How are the frogs doing?
Frogs are at about 410, 430.
Fantastic. And the paladins were also, they were up there with the Hot Rims team last time I checked. So Cold Czar and the team. I'm silent on his microphone, but if he comes back, he'll tell us where they are. Hello,
Cold Czar.
And how are the paladins doing? Where we got you?
We are currently sitting at 344.
Okay, so you're looking like you're in third place at the moment, with the Buckyball at the front on 290, the Elite Racers behind them, and you're looking to be third place of the group teams.
Well, I'm going to have to speed up then if I'm going to, like,
Stand up to my boasting yesterday.
Well, absolutely. We do have a solo pilot who seems to be... Let me see how far off he is. Let's go for Tim Brabston. He's running 12k behind the leaders, so our runner-up is running at about 310 somewhere at the moment, and he's doing it all on his own. He's currently down to 74% hull.
Basically, guys, we are very interested to know the roots of these people of these leading races will be publicised because we're very curious.
Well, I've been following the lead races, and they've got a wonderful setup. They've got an advance tip about a kilometre or 2 kilometres ahead of an individual spotter, and then one racer with wheels on the ground. They have skirted the rims of all of the craters, and they've gone down to one or two. One or two craters and jumped out of them. Sorry, I'm just watching the epic. They're doing most of this with their wheels off the ground. They're actually jumping a lot and boosting a lot. Anybody in the team speak, are you getting an echo from me?
Yes, we are.
Well, I can hear you. Okay, Dave, but whenever anyone else talks, there's echo.
It's when we speak. Although I think he's just changed his voice meter banana settings.
Yep, yeah, that's good.
Okay, are we coming through? Tell me whether it's still coming out the...
That's good. We can hear ourselves think now.
Cross Corp is at 346 kilometers, by the way.
Can you hear me now, boys and girls?
Yes.
Yeah, I can hear you now. So I was just muting my guys for the
moment.
You're
coming out on Twitch.
Yeah, coming out on Twitch, am I echoing here or not?
No, not anymore.
No, you might have had your sound on your Twitch. Yeah, well, basically, we're just saying we're very interested in seeing the route and technique of the lead races. I think at the end there'll be a lot of I'm sure it's all legit.
I hear shenanigans
just,
being
called.
Just
from a curiosity point of view.
No, it is. I mean, I am following these guys, and I've actually had the camera on the lead racers. They are pulling speeds probably consistently around 40. They're jumping obstacles, they're maintaining momentum, and they're just using their boosts. They take off, and then they're leaving their boost because of the low gravity, and they're just using it to spot a landing without damaging themselves. So if I follow the leader at the moment, hang on a second, I'm going to tuck in behind him.
It's all about keeping your wheels off the ground to reduce friction.
And, yes, to reduce... It's on the upslopes. What they're doing is reducing friction on the upslopes. So they're driving up slopes, but when they're landing, if it's a facing slope, they're using their thrusters to soften it quite considerably. So you can see, right, he is now in the air, so watching him at the moment on the live stream. He's jumped, he's pointed it, and he's using the low gravity of the planet, springboard...
He's jumping like they did on the moon.
Yep.
Every single time he drops, he just boosts.
You know, that's impressive driving. Ooh, no, he's just tipped over. No, he's righted it. Bloody hell.
He's good. Let's...
We think is that we will certainly finish, but we're going to need to practice seriously for the next one.
Well, there's going to be a high gravity, I would imagine. There you go. I'm trying to get a close-up on him. For you guys watching on the Twitch stream.
Let's hope that in 2.1, before the next race, Frontier puts in hull reinforcement packages or the SRVs.
Well, they're certainly putting in tracks on the ground, which is going to make my life as a cameraman an awful lot easier.
But also increase the amount of lag, especially when we had the first release of all the commanders. FPS has dropped ridiculously.
Yeah, the one thing I did to counteract that was just quickly go into settings and reduce it to absolute minimum. It didn't
I turned myself down completely.
Yeah, I didn't completely negate it, but it did make it better, though.
Okay, we have a handover. We've got Commander skid to a halt by another one. Okay, I'm videoing this now. We have a live handover between commanders going on. They're tagging each other. Here we go. And I can see a Hutton Mug has been ejected. Here we go, the Hutton Mug has been ejected from the back. These guys are doing it properly. So they've ejected one of the mugs. thanked each other. They've given each other a high five out of the cockpit. He's left the mug behind. It's on the ground here.
They've forgotten their mug. They're going to.
It looks like he's driven. He's driven off without the mug.
No, that was impressive driving for that guy.
Fumbling the
baton. But yeah, Vington, I've sent you a private group request if you want to check in on us again. Actually, I can see Dills. I can see our changeover driver.
Right, swinging around. So they've done a handover. There's been a mug dropped. There may have been, due to the instancing, me not seeing it. They'll have screenshotted that. They'll have videoed it. But certainly the guys have dropped a mug, and the next driver has taken off. The next driver does not look to be as quick as the first driver, though. Let's see what kind of speeds this one's going to be picking up. Okay, so Commander Osric is saying that they dropped the mugs in a virtual handover. Every other drop-off, they've actually crashed somebody's game. So they've dropped the mugs off in good faith, but then carried on with spare ones in the other SRV, which is acceptable. Okay, so we have... God, these guys are... I mean, we might as well rename them frogs. They're jumping about like mad things. This guy is pulling... Let's see what kind of speeds. No, he's not quite got the speed of the original driver. So you have an opportunity to catch up, Elite Racers. Looks like the Buckyball number two man is not pulling the same speed.
Okay, can you see Tim? I can't see Tim.
Yeah, I can see Tim. Do you want me to fly back to him?
No, if he's behind us, that's fine.
Can you do me a favour? Can you come and follow the lead group with me so I don't lose him again?
Yep.
And we'll take... Are you with them? Can you see Commander Osric?
No.
Okay, can you follow me? Should see a white asp ahead of me here.
Roger that, I'll stay on him.
Will you stay on him? I'm going to head back for our tailing group here. Right, Commander Brabston is running about 7Ks behind these guys. He's still going strong. I bet we have nightmare instancing again. Yeah, we do. Commander Brabston is currently below the level of the planet, spinning, which means he's still racing, but we can't see him.
What are rough coordinates?
Rough coordinates at the moment are 45.54113.4.
Going silent again. I said, if any marshals want into our private group, I've already sent some invites out, and just send a request in details in the text chat.
Yeah, I will do. Okay, so I'm Hobo, are you okay to stay with the lead group? Because they haven't got space for winging up. So can you stay with the lead group? I'm going to take two minutes on silent. And then we're going to come back and see how these guys are doing. If anybody can catch up with the Elite Racers, are they in a private group? I think they are, aren't they?
I believe so.
If anybody can see whether they've got a spare space, I may drop down into their group and see how they're doing as well. So I will be back in 4 to 5 minutes. And going silent on the microphone.
User left your channel.
Bear in mind, everybody, that the sound is still live to the Twitch stream, so while I'm away from the keyboard, if you feel like chattering for a minute to keep the Twitch stream entertained, that'd be wonderful. Or if anybody wants to drop down to Edelweiss's or Brett Riverboat's channel, actually, I tell you what, I'm going to do that, and we'll hear their chatter.
User left your channel. User left your channel. User joined your channel. User left your channel.
Well, certainly going faster than I was expecting. However, not quite halfway through yet, and terrain towards the end. I'll be very interested to see how the leading teams cope with.
Yeah, at 3:20, it's starting to get quite, like, say bumpy.
Mm-hmm.
Very bumpy. Be very, very careful. Or you could do what I've just done, which is explode!
That's like 3.78, that's pretty calm.
Not.
I've only got one SRV synth left as well, I mean, the repair.
I'm just having a chat with Commander Klitsch from the Buckyball team, and he's saying you can get 10 miles, or 10 whatever, it's measured in quicker if you start skimming at the surface and start flying over things. That may be a little trick, make sure you keep flight assist off. He's disappeared from my instance.
Yeah, I've opted for the Xbox controller with flight assist off.
The instance in code's definitely been against us today.
I've noticed a weird thing.
399 kilometers, I'm gonna get a beer.
The more people I have around me, the worse the FPS issue on the surface gets. Even if it's like 3 or 4. I'd have to add one them, that's all. Oh, flat surface. I've missed you.
How far is the lead right now?
Not very long ago, they were about 300 kilometers from the finish.
Nice.
That means so pretty much halfway.
Yeah, if I remember, I was like third and I'm 317, so they're probably about 290-something or 280-something.
I keep getting hit by terrain glitches.
User disconnected from your channel.
I just realized I've been on the go yet.
Typical.
I've been on the go for like 3 hours already, geez.
Yep, only 3 hours.
It doesn't feel that long, it's weird. Like when I signed up, I thought, oh my god, this is going to be so next level grind. It's actually a lot of fun.
3 hours, I've only done... I've still got 400 kilometers to go.
And what you've been doing so far is the easy bit.
Oh, cheers.
Yeah, that's what I'm worried about. Because I scouted the route, and towards the end, it looks like... It's just like multiples of Everest.
They're not that tall. Only a couple of kilometers.
It's just like the topography is just terrible, though.
Oh, yeah.
That's why they chose it, isn't it?
Yep, definitely. This route was chosen for a very distinct reason, and that was for a very interesting end to it.
I actually appreciate it, because it's keeping you awake, the whole jumping and that kind of stuff. Because having a flat surface, putting your HOTAS stick forward and just like going to sleep would not be really cool.
So, what do people want next time round? Do you want a high gravity ice world, so you can be slipping and sliding everywhere?
Sounds like it could be fun.
I think something not so long, to be honest.
Hello again, the main channel.
Hello.
Hello, hello.
Hello. Right, Commander Hober. I'm just trying to find these racers.
I've been trying to find races all day, and I'm still failing.
They literally dropped off my instancing, well, probably about a kilometre out of my...
That's fine. I've got them in sight. Could you do me a favour and go back and find one of the other teams now and anchor for me on another team?
Can do.
So if you drop out the wing and you go back and find the Hot Rims, I'd imagine, or see if you could join... Yeah, anybody else?
I got one spot open in my wing. I just got to the end of a cliff and it. I just saw it to come now.
Yeah, I'm currently by myself and not in a wing.
When you guys get to 311, you're gonna see.
User joined your channel.
What was that, 311?
Yeah, 311, you get to like the edge of a cliff and then you get to see the interesting terrain ahead.
Yeah, you get the mountains are coming over the horizon User now.
Left your channel.
Yeah, I'm busy. I'm busy carefully edging down the hill.
Okay,
they did a base jump on.
Yeah, they came from the bottom of the gully and they jetted themselves straight out of it. It was incredible watching them. Right, I'm going to switch and see if I can catch up with the Frogs team now. Madcat, now they sent me a request, I think.
User joined your channel.
Rax Minerva, here we go. I have joined Rax Minerva. I'm going to join their private group now. And see if we can find some of these frogs. So, for everybody listening on the Twitch stream, it's going to go blank for a minute while I switch. And Psycho Cow, how are you? Uh-oh, we've got a message from Goodmane. Goodmane has died. He's blown up. Goodmane has blown up.
Is anybody in his vicinity? Did anyone see him finish? Can anybody spot for him?
Question is, did Goodmane have a spotter?
Unfortunately, I didn't, which is why I'm currently sitting in my ship above the planet. It's a bit of a pain.
Just had a quick chat with Team OP. They're also having instancing issues as well as Hot Rims. People are dropping out very, very close to each other, so they're having to stop, regroup, and find each other.
Okay, we're hitting that four-hour memory leak. This is a known bug that we were warned about by some of the racers. There is a memory leak in the game that about 4 hours in, it starts causing you major problems. So you might want to, one by one, reset if you're in a team and sort of go out of the game and back in again. As long as somebody's still tagging your location, that's good. But you may find you need to do that.
Roger that. I'll let people know downstairs.
Don't you respawn in the same place?
User left your channel.
You do, yes.
I'll do that now then. I'm still in my own solo instance, so...
Yeah, there's any odd occasions where you DC and then end up with your SOV in orbit.
Yeah, however, if you just log out sensibly, then that doesn't happen.
Yeah, yeah, there's no problem there.
Okay.
Excuse me, you're coughing.
I've taken a screenshot, so it's showing my location. Now I'm going to log out and log back in. Hopefully it's going to come back in the same location.